Marcus Smart here, and I gotta tell ya, I remember back when OTRSCentral used to be the Off the Rope show. And I remember these guys used to have so much fun. They legitimately enjoyed themselves, especially the Schlegdaddy probably enjoyed himself each and every single night. But seriously, you had Metal D, you had Marvelous Mark, you had Mr. Rout, you had Tasteless Tony T, the Tasteless One. And my God, what intellectual, stimulating, professional wrestling conversation they used to have. Yes, while some of you may say, when those guys were a part of the show, the cholesterol levels went up and the hairlines receded, by God, they served one important function: to keep the show alive, because the Schlegdaddy stinks. And if you leave him in charge to run it all by himself, you know what happens? You go straight in the sewer. The sewer. The sewer. And that's exactly where OTRSCentral is now. It's in the shits. Because it is the shits. And if it wasn't for yours truly, me, Marcus Smart, this channel would have no purpose. There would be no reason for it to exist, no matter how much the Schlegdaddy thinks differently. And recently, I don't really appreciate, I've never really appreciated, let's be honest, but I really, really haven't appreciated the direction this channel has gone recently. It has veered way off of the deep end, even for the dodo brain Schlegdaddy, I'm just telling you. And furthermore, who the hell calls themselves the Schlegdaddy like he's some type of pimp or something? His name is Jeff. Why doesn't he go by Jeff? We don't need these freaking stupid, ridiculous, homo porn names. Just go by Jeff. Keep it nice and simple. What the hell is a Schlegdaddy anyways? Furthermore, what the hell is an OTRSCentral? And what the hell does that name have anything to do with professional wrestling? Anybody? 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 And that's what I thought. When we get to the point where we start trashing Kenny Omega and we start pooning on Sami Zayn, enough is enough. I've had it. I've had it beyond up to here with these shenanigans, and they're going to stop, and they're going to stop now. The Schlegdaddy wants to get nuts. Oh, we'll get nuts. Nuts, 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 nuts. There's going to be nuts all over his chin after this one. He always wants to crap on everything. Talk about how bad everything is. Well, how about we give him a little bit of a dose of here comes the airplane, open up the hangar. Medicine straight down his poop hole. And when it comes to the Schlegdaddy, it's hard to decipher sometimes which one actually is the poop hole. But I'm going to show his ass. And we're going to enjoy this. It's a good old-fashioned wrestling shooter duel, and I'm destined to win because I'm Marcus Smart. Even my last name says Smart. He has no chance, no chance, none, none whatsoever. And I've got a list here, too. How that dodo brain did it, he's like, oh, look at me, look at my list. Well, we avoid all this stupid, silly shit, and we get right down to business. Let's get this. Marcus Smart's 101 things that are better than OTRSCentral. Are you ready? You damn right you're ready. Let's get to it. Number one, Daniel Bryan, the best motherfucker wrestler in the world. The best motherfucker wrestler of all time. Number two, AJ Styles, also the best motherfucker wrestler in the world. Number three, Chris Jericho. Number four, Finn Balor. That's right, Schlegdaddy. Finn Balor's in the top five. Eat that, bitch. Number five, Brock Lesnar. And while the Schlegdaddy likes to sit here and talk about how Brock only has two moves and a stomp, well, that's two more moves than I've heard he's got in the bedroom with the ladies. Nudge, nudge, wake, wake. Number six, CM Punk. How dare you crap on him for stepping into the octagon. I don't care if it's not a wrestling ring.
It's still CM Punk, and we love you. Philip, you complete me. You complete me.
And the Schlegdaddy can eat shit. Number 7, Dolph Ziggler. He's like a chameleon. He could be everyone. He could be no one. You know what he is, though? Absolutely awesome. Number 8, Kevin Owens. Number 9, Seth Rollins. Yeah, that's right. Number 10, C number 1. Number 11, Cesaro. Number 12, Dean Ambrose. Oh, he likes to quip about, you know, he's come forward crap. Well, let me tell you something. At least he has the ability to grow his hair out long, where he can even consider combing it forward. Yeah, there you go. Number 13, The Club. You got that right. You got that right. Number 14, American Alpha, especially Chad Gable, because he's awesome. And he's like my size. I could get down with him. I could believe in him. Jason Jordan, eh, not so much. Number 15, C number 2. Number 16, the Brian Kendrick. Number 17, Jack Gallagher. Unlike the Schlegdaddy, Jack Gallagher can not only grow a mustache, but Gallagher can grow a majestic mustache. Hey, Schlegdaddy, knock, knock, who's there? Puberty, puberty who? Puberty still hasn't come in your mid-30s, asshole, that's who. Number 18, Drew Gulak. Number 19, Noam Dar and Alicia Fox would most certainly agree. Number 20, C number 1. Number 21, Neville. Number 22, TJ Perkins. TJ Perkins has more personality in his dab, more character in his dab, and in his entrance than the Schlegdaddy could ever dream of, and frankly, this channel has ever possibly had. I'm just saying, it's true. Number 23, James Ellsworth. He might not have a chin, but he has something. Unlike OTRSCentral, he has drawing power. He has that it factor. Number 24, Shane McMahon. Number 25, Enzo Amore. Number 26, Charlotte. How dare you talk about such a strong female in such negative ways. Shame on you. Number 27, Becky Lynch. I wish I had those badass goggles because it would give me an opportunity to peer into the soul of the Schlegdaddy and realize there's nothing in there but tapioca and mayonnaise. Tapioca and mayonnaise, that's right. Number 28, Bailey. Bailey. Oh, do you need a hug, OTRS Central? Well, you ain't getting one because I'm getting them all from Bailey because she's so hot. Maybe not as hot as number 29, Paige. ADR, you lucky, lucky fella. Number 30, Sasha Banks. Number 31, SmackDown. Number 32, 205 Live. Number 33, NXT. And what a joy it would be to someday be able to go down to Full Sail and watch an NXT episode live in person. Speaking of NXT, number 34, Shinsuke Nakamura. Number 35, Samoa Joe. Number 36, Austin Aries. Number 37, Bobby Roode. Number 38, Hideo Itami. Number 39, Asuka. Number 40, William Regal. Are you starting to notice a trend here? There are an awful lot of things at all levels of WWE even that are better than OTRS Central. It's true. It's true. It's true. Number 41, C number 2. Number 42, Mauro Ranallo. Number 43, Corey Graves. Number 44, Renee Young. Number 45, Talking Smack. See, just within WWE, just like that, in like 2 minutes, I came up with 45 things involved with the company that are better than OTRS Central. And that's just WWE. And that's not even the creme de la creme of professional wrestling today. Because I've got more. Let's go to the independents and the other non-WWE companies. Number 46, Kenny Omega. Can you believe that somebody would dare speak of Kenny Omega in such a negative way by not referring to him as the greatest in-ring performer of all time and saying that Okada versus Omega was anything other than 20 stars. 20 stars! 20 stars! Number 47, Okada. Number 48, Tanahashi. Number 49, Naito. Number 50, the Young Bucks. Now, all these older, bitter wrestling fans call them spot monkeys. You know what I call them? The best tag team in professional wrestling today. Box office. Money, bitch. That's what we call them. Number 51, you know, frankly, just everything else that is New Japan, because it is truly the gold standard of professional wrestling in the world. Something OTRSCentral will know absolutely nothing about. Number 52, Broken Matt Hardy. The best character in professional wrestling today. And if OTRSCentral and the Schlegdaddy don't like it, you know what they could be? They could be deleted all over the place. All over. Number 53, Brother Nero. Number 54, King Maxwell. No matter how much OTRSCentral tries to be a babyface in the wrestling community, they cannot measure up to the quality of babyface that is the heir to the throne, King Maxwell. Number 55, Impact Wrestling. Name change, logo change. I like it and I want more. Number 56, ROH. OTRSCentral always craps on ROH, talks about poor this and crappy kicks that. Well, the only thing that are crappy kicks is every video that is uploaded on this channel that does not feature MARKIS SMART. Number 57, Lucha Underground. Number 58, PWG. Number 59, House of Hardcore. Oh, yeah. So, as you can see, there's so much about professional wrestling today that is better than the Schlegdaddy. But wait, there's more. There's more! Let's get to some of the podcasts out there and some of the behind-the-scenes people in the professional wrestling media. Number 60, Dave Meltzer. What more can I say? Other than shame on you for only giving Okada versus Omega 6 stars, you are the one that preaches the gospel of how New Japan is the best professional wrestling company in the world. And for that, sir, we salute you. Number 61, Brian Alvarez. While you'll never be Dave Meltzer, you do your best trying to be a close second. Number 62, the Sala Monster. He is everything the Schlegdaddy can't be and never will be. The Sound Off podcast is everything OTRSCentral can't be and will never be. Number 63, the Wrestling Observer Newsletter. Unlike a certain channel's ID in the past, at least the Wrestling Observer Newsletter charges you for actual news. I'm just saying. I'll be here all week, thank you. Number 64, MLW Radio. Number 65, Don Tony. While I think he's very, very mean to some of the independent professional wrestling scene, he likes Donald Trump. MARKIS SMART believes in Donald Trump. And all of us together can hashtag Make America Great Again. Thank you. Number 66, Stone Cold Podcast. Number 67, The Ross Report. Number 68, NoDQ.com. Any website that calls Roman Reigns the worst wrestler and the most overused wrestler of the year is okie dokie in my book, doesn't matter how it looks. Number 69, Wrestling Inc. For a Chop Shop dirt sheet, they do a hell of a job. Salute to you, Raj Giri. But wait, there's more. You're like, well, what about the channels on YouTube? I've wasted so many years watching Off the Roof Show, now OTRSCentral, the Schlegdaddy. I need options. I need alternatives. Well, let me tell you something. There are all kinds out there, and they're so much better than what OTRSCentral could ever be. Number 70, What Culture WWE? Brits That Talk Wrestling. It's like British Fist, but with an audience and better. Number 71, JD from NY206. Sami Zayn for the Royal Rumble, yes. You're goddamn right. Cruiserweights on Raw is a great idea. You're goddamn right. MARKIS SMART is a very big fan of JD from NY206. Absolutely. Number 72, Wrestling with Regret. It's like OTRSCentral viewers, every time they click on the video, they're wrestling with the regret of why the hell they continue to watch this crap. And in particular, this crappy channel with the crappy host Schlegdaddy. Again, who calls himself Schlegdaddy? This is the type of stuff that makes it difficult for the real professional wrestling fans like myself. Guys like the Schlegdaddy make it seem like we're just a bunch of dumb marks that live in her mama's basement.
It's true. It's because of people like him.
Number 73, Joe Cronin Show. Number 74, Steven Larson. Number 75, Good Mic Work. Although I have a bone to pick with Good Mic Work. Your podcasts are great. Your videos are brilliant. But we don't get enough of them. Like, this should be your life, Good Mic Work. This should be the only thing you ever do. Because you bring some sanity to the internet wrestling community. You do. You do. You do. Number 76, Bruce Blitz. Because he loves TNA, hates John Cena, but he's not Fool Killer. Because we don't like Fool Killer. Because he has a big schnoz. And he used to beef with Smokey. Now think about that. Think about that. In the grand scheme of things, the only great thing the OTR Essential has ever put out, other than Mr. Rout, Marvelous Mark, Metal D, and Tasteless Tony T, was Smokey, a gray cat with an imaginary voice that's been gone for over 3 years now. But Fool Killer feuded with the cat, so he's on the shit list. Number 77, Miracle Man, because he fights a war of positivity. Absolutely. Number 78, Wizza Wiza, I don't know how you say it now, but you're not Deluxeman, therefore you get on the list. You're not some phony. You rock the Bullet Club merchandise, which makes you okay in my book. You don't sit there and talk about this and that and preach the gospel of guys like Sami Zayn and Kenny Omega and then wear a Hulk Hogan hat in your videos. Number 79, Andre Corbell. Another guy who fights the good fight against the hate from channels like OTRS Central on Impact Wrestling. Number 80 of the Brad Rules. The Brad does rule because he rants and he raves, and whether people watch or not, whether people listen or not, or whether they care or not, he still does it. He still cares. And he's also a Trump guy, just like Marcus Smart. Make America great again is what we're going to do, Brad Rules and Don Tony. Do you hear me? Number 81, Tom Cushion. Number 82, OSW Review. Unlike OTR Essential, when they do a retro review, it's interesting and enlightening, if you know what I mean. Number 83, Grimm's Toy Show. Number 84, CM Pulse. And then we get to the real meat and potatoes. Number 85, The Wrestling Jesus. He is the one. He's called the Wrestling Jesus for a reason. And whether you hate him or you love him, you can't get enough of him. You just want to grab him by the hat and the scruffy little beard, and you want to go, who's a good wrestling Jesus? Who's a good wrestling Jesus? He's the innovator, the originator. Whereas Jeff, the Schlegdaddy, is the ripoffinator, okay? I'm just saying, when you think about real personality and an ability to connect with the audience, who is better than the Wrestling Jesus? I'm just saying. I'm just saying. Where are we at? I've lost track. Number 86, Sean's View Entertainment. He does a phenomenal job of exposing you to the breaking news of WWE for educational purposes. He lives it. He believes it. He is it. Where the Schlegdaddy will go on freaking lazy-ass sabbaticals for months at a time, Sean's View lives it. He is YouTube each and every single day. And for that, sir, again, I salute you. I do. Number 87, Bill and Doug, please come back. You were one of the innovators, the originators. You were the foundation of the YouTube wrestling community. Please come back home. No more crappy Cowboys videos that are still eminently better than anything OTRSCentral does. Number 88, Truth Slayer. Another one of the pillars, the bedrocks of the internet wrestling community. He gives you the straight dope on TNA, and in particular ROH and New Japan. He likes them because they're awesome. I like him because he's awesome, and he's not trademark 629 who can eat shit. Eat shit. Look at me. I'm doing retro WrestleMania reviews while picking my last place fantasy football team in my fantasy football draft. You don't see any of those side jinks with freaking Truth Slayer, we get straight to the point. It's all about nuts and bolts and star ratings of phenomenal ROH and New Japan action. Number 89, ROH Styles 23. His name is ROH. It's Styles. What more do you need to say? Again, none of these characters, none of this bullshit. We get straight to the point of talking about great ROH professional wrestling action. And then, of course, number 90, PS Power. There is something redeeming about a guy with a 1990s emo haircut with seemingly the webcam to match. I'm just saying. And his old mantra of save WWE, support TNA, when I'm still down with that, save WWE, support Impact Wrestling, hooray! We need you back, PS Power, we really do. But, you know, for those of you that are sitting there and saying, oh, you're just sitting there crapping on OTRSCentral and the Schlegdaddy, you can't have fun, that is balderdash, I most certainly can. And I'll prove it to you right now. Look at the next numbers. Number 91, nausea. Number 92, heartburn. Number 93, indigestion. Number 94, upset stomach. Number 95, diarrhea. That's right, nausea, heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, and diarrhea. Easy for me to say. All five of them together, singularly, doesn't matter. They're all eminently better than OTRSCentral. Because unlike OTRSCentral, eventually those symptoms stop. And you move on, and you get some relief from it. But as long as you're a subscriber to this channel, you can never get away from the dookie that is this crap. Number 96, masturbation. And believe me, if anybody knows about masturbation, it's the Schlegdaddy. He just looks like somebody that yurts it multiple times a day. He's probably a nasty fucker. And when you look at him with his eye twitch and his messed up teeth, what woman would want him? Seriously, he has to masturbate. And granted, there's nothing wrong with masturbation. We're just saying, because at the end of the day, you know, when you talk about watching Impact Wrestling and ROH and Lucha Underground and PWG and New Japan and NOAH and all the other great professional wrestling that's out there, you know, we could have women all day if we chose. But it's the curse of being a fan of such great professional wrestling. Who needs a woman? And frankly, who has time for a woman? So at the end of the day, it's much better to masturbate because it just saves broken hearts. I mean, because you got to choose between a woman and Okada versus Kenny Omega. And the choice is very obvious. A thank you. And certainly, masturbation is much better than watching OTRSCentral. And in particular, who would masturbate to the Schlegdaddy's face? I'm just saying. But let's bring it home here. We've got a few more to get through. We need to get serious. Here we go. Five more to go. Number 97, Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan. Not only is he the best motherfucking wrestler in the world of all time in history, but he is the guy that saved WrestleMania 30, that made WrestleMania 30, and had the greatest WrestleMania moment of all time. Of all time. You could take your Hogan body slamming Andre, and you could shove it straight up your keister. Give me Daniel Bryan running through the Breakfast Club that night in New Orleans. It was magic. And in my pants, too, going back to number 96. Number 98, AJ Styles, the 2016 Superstar of the Year, and easily, arguably, beyond question, one of the greatest motherfucking wrestlers of all time. Number 99, Kenny Omega. Watch his match with Okada at Wrestle Kingdom 11, and I rest my case. Kenny Omega, good God Almighty, Kenny Omega. You like how I did that, Schlegdaddy? Yeah, up yours. Number 100, Marcus Smart. Me. I'm better than anything else on OTRSCentral, period. You get straight nuts and bolts professional wrestling talk. I bring you the counterbalance to the shit that is everything pretty much that the Schlegdaddy ever says. So I am clearly superior to this channel. And the 101st and final, but most certainly not least, of the things out there better than OTRSCentral. And again, we could come up with so many more. We could have come up with 1,001, 5,001. But in the interest of time, this is what we got. The number 101 thing that is better than OTRSCentral and Schlegdaddy. You better listen real close. It's Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn! He is the one, the chosen one, that should go on to win the 2017 WWE Royal Rumble and then go on to main event WrestleMania 33. When you talk about the look, the in-ring abilities, the personality, the charisma, the gimmick, ole, 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 he has it all. He is everything that Roman Reigns isn't, and that is talented. And Sami Zayn is one of the most wonderful people in the wrestling business, one of the most talented people in the wrestling business, and one of the best in-ring performers in the professional wrestling business. While the Schlegdaddy beats off to who has in Braun Strowman, we'll sit there and enjoy the magnificence of the flips and the kicks and the false finishes of Sami Zayn. And when we're all done, sure. He moonlights as an Uber driver. Who cares? It's just another thing that just accentuates how Sami Zayn is better than OTRSCentral. At the end of the day, I hope you get one thing out of this video above all else. And you know what that is? Is that this channel absolutely sucks. And there are so many things better out there than OTRSCentral. And it's a shame what the Schlegdaddy has done to this once great institution. I can't even finish that thought with a straight face. The Schlegdaddy can kiss my ass. If it's a war he wants, it's a war he'll get. And it is a war I will win. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. The war has just begun. OTRSCentral and Schlegdaddy can kiss my ass.